Hello friends, today we will discuss repositories architectural style. Repositories architectural style comes in two flavors. If the transaction is triggering some modules, then we use database. And there's another type of repository architectural style, which is called Blackboard. We will be discussing Blackboard repositories architecture style from Software Architecture book. This book is written by David and Mary, and it can be found online. You can Google it. So let's discuss what is Blackboard repository architecture style is. In Blackboard or repository architecture style, there are two main data structures. One is called Blackboard structure. It has the shared data, which is generally organized in hierarchical structure required by the application. So whenever there's some data state changes, it may trigger other components. Those are called knowledge sources. Generally, in this kind of systems, there is one Blackboard component and multiple knowledge sources components. So these knowledge sources trigger in some coordination, some processing, whenever the data state changes in repository, changes in Blackboard component. We can see there are three major actors in this architectural style. One is Blackboard. Blackboard is shared data. Whenever some data changes happen, Blackboard will invoke other knowledge sources to perform some processing. Blackboard. Then there are knowledge sources components. These components does some processing based on some interesting event happened or did some interesting data change happen in Blackboard component. And there's a finding control. Blackboard component decides he is going to invoke, trigger which knowledge source, in which sequence, in what manner. So let's go into example. So if we can see, this architecture is more kind of publisher subscriber kind of pattern. So Blackboard is whenever some interesting data change happens in Blackboard components, it publishes that event and triggers all the knowledge sources that are subscribed to this event. So what is the difference between publisher subscriber and repositories architecture style? The difference is in a repositories architecture style, we store the data, we persist the data in some systems database. So let's look into some examples. This Blackboard repositories architecture style will make more sense if we look into examples. So first example is it's used when you require very complex processing of signal. For example, some speech processing or some pattern recognition. The second example is if we need batch sequencing of some data that need to be stored in some global database. So if we have some data that need to be put in certain sequence or process, so Blackboard component will call knowledge sources to do that processing so that it can be saved in a particular sequence in a global database. That's another example. And a lot of programming environments, they use this kind of architectural pattern where you have a brain or Blackboard which stores the data, and it may be calling other modules to do some processing. So friends, today we discussed Blackboard repositories architecture style. So if you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to this channel for your regular updates. Also connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn, if you like small summaries of the video. I will be posting a lot of small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.